Nola Jet here at Mother's Restaurant. Good stuff in here, yeah.
Welcome to Nola Jet. Let the good times roll.
In this episode of our restaurant review vlog, we visit Mother's Restaurant to feast on some great New Orleans food with seafood gumbo, shrimp creole, crawfish etouffee, and a roast beef po' boy for this New Orleans Creole food review video. Mother's Restaurant is located in the New Orleans Central Business District at 401 Poydras Street, just four blocks from the French Quarter, where they opened 83 years ago, back in 1938. Mother's Restaurant is very popular with tourists and some locals, as seen by the frequently long lines to get into this popular spot. This is one of the only spots that serves both a sliced meat roast beef po' boy, which also has debris on it, along with a po' boy filled with only roast beef debris, as most restaurants typically serve just one of these two types of roast beef po' boy. Mother's Restaurant got their start as a po' boy joint that became famous for making New Orleans' favorite sandwich, which has long been the poor boy, or po' boy, as it has come to be called, and over the years they've added a lot more New Orleans food options to their menu, establishing 83 years of New Orleans food history behind them. In this video, we'll be covering two separate visits I made, and things have certainly changed since my first visit. They are no longer offering their daily specials due to the supply limitations of our current situation we're in, but they are continuing with all the other menu items that they have. So let's go ahead and head on inside here and check this place out. So you walk in, they hand you a menu, and then you go stand in the cafeteria style line, where you would usually see some of the specials, but we only have the menu to look at today. So usually there's a lot more people in line, but with our ongoing situation, we've had a lot less tourists still. So there are a handful of tourists in here and a few locals today. Typically there's a lot more people in here, but you can see they have a lot of great food here in the cafeteria line. And even though it's covered up, it still looks mighty delicious. So they have their chalkboard menu that would often have some of the specials, but those are just regular menu items up there. And we'll look at the menu here in a minute. So as we look through, you see this is just kind of your typical cafeteria style setup, which a lot of restaurants in the Central Business District have a similar setup, although that is disappearing in some places, sadly. And you can see some great desserts right there too. Oh yeah. So before we get up to the cash register lady to order, we need to take a look at the menu to see what we're going to order today. So they have the entire menu available anytime and breakfast served all day, but we're going to skip the breakfast part and go right into the rest of the menu here. They have their famous Verdi special, which is ham with roast beef and roast beef debris. Then they have the Ralph, which is a Verdi with Swiss or American cheese. A John G, which is ham, turkey, roast beef, and debris. Then the Turkey Ferdy, which is turkey with ham or roast beef, debris, and au jus. Then just the ham. Then they have the regular roast beef, and that comes with debris also. Then they have a turkey. Then they have just a roast beef debris with only the debris on the po' boy. Then they have a sausage po' boy. Then they have a chicken breast po' boy. A Gulf shrimp po' boy, you can get it fried or grilled. An oyster. A combo of shrimp and oyster, a catfish, and a soft-shell crab po' boy. Then they have their plates with the world's best baked ham dinner, red beans and rice, Jerry's jambalaya, crawfish etouffee, shrimp creole, quarter-fried chicken, half-fried chicken, and combination platter. Then we have seafood with a seafood platter with shrimp, oysters, and catfish, seafood platter, extra extra, crawfish etouffee, Jerry's jambalaya, shrimp, oysters, and catfish, seafood platter with soft-shell crab platter, seafood half and half, choose two half portions of shrimp, oysters, or catfish, fried oyster plate, Gulf shrimp plate, catfish plate, mother's favorite, seafood gumbo, maize filet gumbo, shrimp creole, red beans and rice, Jerry's jambalaya, crawfish etouffee, then salads with garden salad, chef salad, chicken salad, Gulf shrimp salad, catfish salad, and fried oyster salad. Then we have side dishes with red beans and rice, cabbage, turnip greens, Jake's green beans with tomatoes, french fries, potato salad, grits and cheese grits, then child's plates. Then for dessert, we have bread pudding with brandy sauce, pie, pecan or sweet potato, rich chocolate brownies, house baked cookies. Beverages, you have mother's coffee and chicory, orange juice, milk, soft drink, lemonade, iced tea, bottled water. Then spirits, Mother's Spicy Bloody Mary, mimosas, cocktails, beer, and then premium or imported beer and wine. So I have to say, this was one of the shortest lines I've ever seen at Mother's Restaurant before. The last time I came, it was a relatively short line, but there were a lot more people than there were today. So I came a little bit later. It was right before 3 o'clock, so there were still a fair number of people in here for that later afternoon time. And now we're up to the cash register lady, so we gotta figure out what we're gonna get for our order. And they have a couple of draft beers back there too, but we're not gonna do that today. So we'll pay for our order and review it when we get back to the table and let you see what the price of it was. This is not the cheapest place for what we're gonna be eating today, but we'll get to enjoy it nonetheless. So they have a lot of great old pictures of so many interesting things to see in here. So you definitely want to plan a little time to enjoy yourself and walk around. So you've got the main front little room here right next to the cafeteria selection area. But then they have bigger rooms here on the back side. So let's take a little walk around and you just see all the walls are covered in pictures and photos. And you really want to check it out. That's the kitchen to the left. Then they have a nice big room over here. So you see, this holds a lot more people in this room. And you've got plenty of space to spread out in here and more pictures. So there's a lot of interesting areas and spaces in here. But overall, it looks a lot like any other diner you might see in a lot of places until you look closer and notice how old the brickwork is. Some of the things on the ceiling. So this is a really interesting door here that's obviously pretty old that they have that divides the spaces. And here we are looking back towards that main dining room next to the cafeteria. And then there's the kitchen again. And if you see the bathroom sign, you follow that and that will take you back to a private room they have for event rentals, which is pretty cool. So when you go back in this area, you've got another nice space where you can have a private event. So this will hold quite a lot of people. So for a larger venue, that's a pretty nice area. So now we're taking a seat. See, they have plenty of hot sauce for me, my favorite Tabasco. All right, so we're gonna start off with a baked spaghetti, a seafood gumbo, a crawfish etouffee, and cabbage, and I got an iced tea to drink. So this little feast here set me back $30, and this was back in March of 2020. We're gonna start out with the cabbage now. So they definitely have a good cabbage, and corned beef and cabbage is their usual Tuesday special. You know, like I said earlier, sadly they're not doing their daily specials right now, but it's a good cabbage. Next, we're gonna dig into the seafood gumbo, and oh wow, look at all these shrimp in there. Oh yes, looks like there's a good amount of seafood when I first dug in, but then, there's a whole bunch of rice in here too though. I'm thinking it's definitely more rice than gumbo, so I was a little disappointed in that. The gumbo does have good flavor. I enjoy the shrimp quite a bit. The Tabasco sauce definitely kicked it up a good deal. The rice is definitely overkill, though. This is probably the most rice I've ever had at a gumbo. Wow. So the gumbo is good, but then it was more than half rice, which I've never had this much rice in a gumbo. This is absolutely a ripoff because of too much rice. But here we have the crawfish etouffee that looks beautiful. Ooh, look at this. So it looks like they did not put as much rice in this. So the crawfish etouffee certainly looks a little more balanced. And these crawfish are really large. Ooh, this is beautiful. And March is right in there crawfish season, so it's a perfect time to have crawfish. This video was filmed right when Bonton Cafe, which is nearby here, was in the process of closing, which is a very sad thing, but I do have a video on that. If you haven't seen it, I'll put a link to it up above here. Next, we're gonna be trying the baked spaghetti, so nothing complicated about this, just your basic spaghetti with a lot of delicious melted cheese on it. So let's give it a little bite. A little bit like a casserole. It's a decent little dish, nothing too special though. My next meal in November of 2021, which was $30.30, I had a shrimp creole and a large debris po' boy. This is some really beautiful looking shrimp creole. And of course, I've got to add a little hot sauce, Tabasco style. Now, interestingly enough, I paid the same price pretty much that I paid for my previous meal, but I got less food, so there's definitely food inflation. right, let's give the shrimp creole a taste. It really looks delicious. That really bright red from the tomato sauce it's in. And oh yes, great flavor and taste. So this is a really good version of a shrimp creole. I am enjoying it. It's definitely very well put together. Although I'm not getting a lot of vegetables like some other versions do, so this one is definitely much more saucy without a lot of chunkiness. I know at Coop's Place, theirs is probably the chunkiest and crunchiest of any I've had. I do enjoy Coop's Place shrimp creole as well. This one's definitely a different variety. There's no two exactly alike that I've experienced, but this certainly has been an easy eating version, and I have enjoyed it most definitely. A lot of good flavor in here. It's good stuff. Pretty good version of shrimp creole. Last bite. Now that I've totally destroyed the shrimp creole, destroy the subscribe button. Give this video a thumbs up. Comment below. Let me know what you thought about this meal so far. And while you're down there, check out the link to my Patreon account because I do work for tips and I appreciate any help with that. And now it's time for the roast beef debris po' boy. So this is one of the few places that has both a regular roast beef and a debris roast beef. The regular roast beef has debris on it, but you don't find many places that have both. So this is just the regular debris. Structural integrity is absolutely failing. There's just so much debris gravy in the bottom slice of bread that it's just falling apart because it's so soaked. Oh, it's delicious. It's just not the easiest thing to eat.
And unlike other places, when you get a dressed, it's cabbage instead of lettuce. Gravy everywhere.
There's literally just beef juices squirting out all over the place. The bread is completely soaked through. The plate is soaked with beef juices. There's delicious beefy goodness all over the place. And then I can't even get a good grip on this thing because the bread is literally just mush underneath because there's so much meat juice everywhere. This is great, but hard to eat. Most of the other roast beef debris style po' boys around town have a much more thick gravy style texture to them. This one's just very liquid, so hey, it's still good.
The lower part of the bread is so moist from the gravy, it's disintegrating almost.
I have to say, I do miss more of the crunchy French bread texture you get with the thicker gravy styles. The mushy bread texture on the bottom part of the bread of this po' boy is not as appealing as a nice crunchy French loaf that we're usually accustomed to. The overall flavor is still pretty good, but that mush texture is a little distracting, so the thicker gravy style could be an improvement I wouldn't mind seeing. Because, you know, mushy bread's usually just not the best thing.
Time to clean up third meal here.
So, we like to rank our po' boys in New Orleans by the number of napkins, but I'm going to be all neat and use my fork instead of my hands for this little leftover part, and as we call it, third meal, because you got your third section after your first and second halves of your po' boy to eat. And usually I would say this is probably about a 10 napkin po' boy. I don't know what's going on though. They only gave me one napkin today here, and just the other day at Bernie Mart, they didn't have any napkins, so I don't know if there's a napkin shortage going on in the city or what, Although there is a sink here, and I did wash my hands twice, and they did have napkins at least at the sink. So that was at least a useful way to clean up a little more than usual.
The cabbage is really good. It gives it a little extra crunch above what the normal lettuce does.
Cabbage also has more flavor than the lettuce, I would say, too. So it's got really nice crunch, really good flavor, and I think it really goes well with the beef. So that is a great little thing they've done here that sets them apart from a lot of other places. So it's like a Vietnamese banh mi also does a little extra stuff to kick their po' boys up. So that's really nice how different places have their own unique take and approach to the po' boy, the official sandwich of New Orleans. So just like I've destroyed this po' boy, go ahead and destroy that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, comment below, let me know what you thought about this po' boy. While you're down there, check out the link to my Patreon account because I do work for tips and I appreciate any help with that. And also refer this video to any of your friends or contacts who would enjoy it, as it really would help the channel expand and keep getting more viewers. Now, as I mentioned earlier during the first part of this video, that was during the time when Bon Ton Cafe was closing. And unfortunately, today when I was filming the second part of this video, I found out that Upper Line Restaurant in Uptown New Orleans is closing forever. So another great loss to our restaurant culture.
Thanks for watching, I really appreciate it. And if you would just click on the little circle here with a picture of my head in there and subscribe to the No Legit channel, it would really help me a lot. I really appreciate it. Thank you.